This is a song from my album, Powers of Ten, called Epilogue for Lisa. It's one of my favorite songs, and it's also one of my favorite styles of playing the guitar, playing real slow and expressively. And then after I finish, I'm going to talk about some of the ways I've played in that, and I think you could learn from that. ¶¶ And I use the vibrato on this song in a way that's not blatantly vibrato. A lot of times people use it for... I'm using it in a very subtle fashion in this song to kind of emulate the way vocalists vibrato. Because on guitar, typically when you vibrato with your fingers, you're just moving the pitch up. You're oscillating it up from the original pitch. But when you vibrato with the vibrato bar, you're getting a smooth up and down. You're going below the pitch and above the pitch, and it has a very smooth sound. Also, you can bend up to notes in a certain way that you can't really do with your fingers. Or if you did, it would require a lot of thought because you'd have to go down a half step and do things such as that. So in phrases like... If I didn't use the vibrato, I'd have to do it like... Or something like that, it'd be very awkward in a way. And also with the vibrato, you can get a much smoother response. I try to use a lot of different speeds for expressive purpose of vibrato. Sometimes it's effective to do a fast vibrato, and sometimes very, very slow. And then sometimes you can use a real extreme vibrato that may seem out of context sometimes, but if you just touch on it in a certain way, it'll give a certain character to it. Like sometimes in the phrase in that song, I'll go... And it just, you just kind of touch on it for a minute, like... The guy that does some extreme vibratos on the guitar that's influenced me and, you know, a lot of people a lot is Jeff Beck. He does a lot of things like that. Sometimes he'll play something with just a little bit of something...